First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello, lovely Sagittarius. This is your reading for July 2017, your tarotscope, angelscope and quick astrological overview. So for you, for most of July, end of June and for most of July, the emphasis is going to be on your 8th house. So you're going to have the sun in the 8th house in Cancer. So you're going to be thinking very much about intimacy, trust issues, boundaries, where you put your boundaries down. It's also to do with, it can be to do with other people's money, money in big organisations. We're going to focus on the intimacy aspect, and we're going to see what comes up, because you've got, we're looking at Cancer, we're looking at self-nurturing, we're looking at emotional security and the feeling of safety, and it just seems to flow much more with your sense of boundaries and your sense of intimacy and self-trust, and that's what I'm feeling I want to focus on for you. So for the month of July, let's see where we are. Heartache and loss. Okay, so Sag, for some Sages there is going to be a little bit of a sense of grieving something, the loss of something or someone. It could be a sense of betrayal or loss over a career opportunity, or it could be a sense of loss over something more emotional. It could just be a general sense of feeling alone, of feeling lonely, feeling that you'd like to be with someone, or it could just be just a sense of, you know, just feeling a little bit all at sea and not quite sure where you are with what you're doing. Now this, don't get, you know, into that, because this is just the one influence. We've got a whole load of other cards to look at, and that just seems to be a theme that could be in the air for you as you come to this time of the year. And by no means does it say what's going to be happening over the whole of the month. So what crosses that light? So what crosses that is that this has given you the opportunity, this sense of aloneness or disappointment or frustration, whatever it is, has given you an opportunity to discover yourself, to discover your inner light, to discover your inner resources and your ability to just be who you came here to be. You know, you, it's not always about you being the party starter and the razzle dazzler. Sometimes we all come to that point where we have to go inside to meet our God, if you like, to meet that divine essence and to just be able to really connect with that truer, deeper sense of light. And at the same time, I also feel that you are going to start to emerge from this period with a lighter sense of who you actually are. So hopefully a bit of the party animal will be coming back, and that will help you with your sense of self-trust and being able to be open again to intimacy, because at the moment it doesn't look great. It looks as if there is that potential, but it's not necessarily being explored, or it's not being explored in the way that you would want it to, and that you're being asked to focus on career goals or spiritual development or becoming more yourself. And let's just see how that shapes up with as the reading goes on, with your potential for developing more intimacy. Okay, so set the timer. Okay. So what's above you? Patience and planning. So it's going to take time for you to put together something that you're working on at the moment. And it might feel as if that's the way it's been for a long time, but it's actually what you really need to be aware of at the moment, that it takes time to put most things together. It can take time to put together an entire reality in terms of where you feel you need to be next, where you feel you're moving to, and what you feel you came here to do. So give that just a bit more time, because there are projects on the table, is what I'm seeing. It's like there are contracts kind of piling up or waiting to come in, things waiting to happen, and things that need and require your attention. So July, it feels as if July is going to be possibly another one of those months when things start coming in, which is a great thing if you're looking at you know, the financial aspect of the eighth house, which means that you could get quite a big payout, you could get some sort of a win coming in terms of a contract that you get to sign. So let's just have a look. But the patience and planning is saying make sure that you check things out properly, that you get someone to look through thoroughly, and that you do put your focus on that, rather than, you know, don't be maudlin or concerned about anything that's happening in the emotional arena, because that's not where your focus needs to be at the moment. That will come later in the year, I feel. Conflict and defeat. So there's some sense of you having this sort of slightly shaky foundation as you come into July, just this slightly shaky foundation of, oh my God, you know, I thought that was going to work out, it didn't work out. Why didn't it work out? Why isn't this sort of thing working out? So possibly there was a love interest or something that was looking as if it might happen, but it hasn't really come to anything. Or it could have been a project that fell apart at the last minute. Either way, you're not defeated by any means. You are just given another opportunity to plan things more carefully and to learn, you know, and to grow and evolve from that experience, to rise phoenix-like from the ashes, is what I've just heard from my guides, which kind of works with all of that light, doesn't it? Okay, so, and you know, the phoenix and the flames and the fire, you're all about the fire. So, you know, remember that inner fire that's there inside you all the time, just burning and looking and leaping up towards new experiences and new growth and new possibilities and excitement, and allow that to fill you up and push you forward. Okay. Mental conflict. Okay, so there's been a lot of thinking, a lot of torturing yourself over things that, you know, don't need to be a torture, things that you do not need to be concerning yourself with. Let go, let go, let go. Some of the decisions that you're trying to make or that you were trying to make just recently, it's kind of as if they're sort of starting to work themselves out and the decisions have made themselves in a way. So things are going to seem a lot clearer now moving into this period. So this is what's just gone. This is like June and now you're moving into July. Let's see what you're moving into. Oh, wow. Okay. Harmony. So that's really lovely. So either you're about to come into a really nice connection or you're about to come into a phase of harmony in a connection that already exists, or this is just more personal harmony within yourself where you start to feel calm and a little bit more at peace with the things that have happened really for quite a long period. And I know this is about the eighth house, but I've just heard 8 years. So for a period of 8 years for some Sagis, there's been a lot of upheaval and change, and things start to look good for a while, then they kind of don't work out, and these disappointments. And don't be defeated. You are the creator. Don't let that be your predominant thought. Okay. Recognition and reward. Okay, so you want recognition and reward for the work that you're doing, but for the right work. Yes, there are rewards for some work that you're doing, and the perception of you, I feel, for some of you Sagittarius, is far greater. The public perception of you is greater than the perception that you have of yourself. So I get this sense that it's like, yeah, I know I got that, but what I really want is that. It's that sort of energy, okay? I want to be recognized for that part of myself, okay? And that's, someone else had that, it's interesting. Okay, so environment, obstacles and challenges, lots of obstacles and challenges to come, to overcome, not to come, to overcome. That's what where you are now, currently, overcoming obstacles and challenges and clearing the way for a better time ahead. From now towards December, the rest of the year, okay? So just keep focusing on clearing those channels because something much nicer is coming in. Clearing those challenges, sorry. Yes, and clearing the channels as well. Okay, interesting that that came out. So you could do with clearing your energy if you've been through a lot of thinking and overthinking and stress. Make sure your energy is nice and clear so that you can continue to think clearly, let the light in, let it wash away the doubt and think positively again and allow this harmony to come in when it comes. Okay, that looks really lovely. Okay, so hopes and fears, passion ignited. Okay, so for some Sagittarius, it will be a connection that isn't quite what it was, that needs reviving. For some, it will be you just don't feel passionately about your work at the moment and you want to feel better, you want to feel that original passion. It's like, oh my God, how much more of this is there to do? And you're, you know, really, really wanting to feel that passion, feel that excitement again, the original excitement that you felt when you first, because there's a gap sometimes, isn't there, between creating something really special and amazing and having it actually go out into the world in the way that we would like it to. And sometimes in that gap, we can lose sight of what we did originally and why we did it. And for you, igniting that passion is going to be about going back to that original vision. And in other words, remembering why you did it, looking at it again, or even creating something else, something completely new, so that you can get excited about your work again. And if it is a relationship, a connection, it's almost as if there's a longing for something to be reignited, something that exists, or you know, just wanting to change the way you feel about love in general. Okay, and how this relates to your eighth house and that whole trust and intimacy thing, it just looks as if there's a part of you that doesn't really trust that something can remain passionate and ignited, and it's almost as if you want that. You want that more than anything. You almost want that more than the harmony. We know that you're restless, that you can get bored very easily, that you need stimulation and excitement and you need entertaining. So, you know, just give yourself, let yourself off the hook and let this light come from within you. Let yourself reignite the passion around your purpose, your work, your mission, so that when a relationship or a connection comes in, or the one that's already there, whatever the case is, it doesn't have to fill that gap. It doesn't have to set you on fire. It doesn't have to be the full party. It's a part of your life that is exciting and thrilling and wonderful, but there are other things that light you up and other things that make you feel great about life. Rediscover the passion that you have for your soul mission is what I'm hearing. Okay, so that's going to be a really good thing for you to do in July. It's going to be really important, because I feel between July and September is going to be an important turning point for you in a lot of areas, and I'm not sure why, but that's just what I'm feeling. So the outcome, if you continue in this way and you ignite your passion in your work, because also that's where your rewards are going to come from. It's almost as if things, I've just heard lackluster. Things have become a bit lackluster, and because of that, people are picking up that lackluster energy from you, and that's why you're not manifesting in the way that you know you can, the way that you used to do. Okay, so final outcome, if you reawaken your passion and get that energy flowing again, is spiritual strength. That's wonderful. With spiritual strength, you can do anything, really, you know, because what that also says is your higher self, your guides, all the higher divine aspects, your God, your inner being, is totally on board with what you're doing right now. So just take a second to absorb that, Saj, and just really get that message. Because that's all you really need. If that's the truth of things, you can't fail. So that's your outcome, and I'm not going to pick another outcome card because that's just too perfect. We're going to have a quick look at, let's look at angels, gods and goddesses, seeing as your sign is all about belief and higher learning and philosophy. Let's go there. So we're looking for the past, present and future overview for Sagittarius. What do Sagittarius need to know for July that will place all of this in context? The desire for intimacy, the desire for an upgrade in material circumstances, and the desire for passion reignited. Okay, great. So past, angel of visions. Someone is not revealing part of the story. Trust your feelings over what others say. Right, so in the past, it feels as if there has been talk, but not a lot of movement forward. This is in the area of trust and intimacy, I'm hearing quite clearly. A lot of talk, but not moving forward. And in a sense, you have a feeling of why this could be, that maybe it's just not right, or maybe it's not the right time, or maybe there's more that you need to do, and you're being asked to trust that. In fact, this is the past, so you've already taken that on board, and in a sense, you've moved away from chasing and following something doggedly, because it was just too sticky. It just wasn't really, it felt as if there was something you didn't understand about what was going on, and you pulled away. Okay, so where we find you now is emerging. So this is just what we've said, that out of heartache and loss, your true inner being begins to shine and to emerge. And this says it's time for the real you to emerge. So because of all this questioning and frustration, you've been allowed an opportunity to do some deep soul searching. And you might feel you've been doing that all your life. You might be fed up with it, but you really, 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 really know who you are now. You really do. And that true self is in the process of emerging. And there is more emergence to come. And this is what I feel is happening between July and September. Okay, so moving into the future. So for the whole of July, so you have this period of awakening to the truth of things and giving yourself time to emerge in your full capacities to become the very best version of you that you can be. And then you have the goddess of shadows. What you perceive to be your dark side holds your hidden treasure. So in other words, what I feel is sometimes you get fed up of yourself, of, you know, oh, it's like I need everything to be up and upbeat and, you know, always moving and partying and all of this. And I just feel that your inner light, your inner being, your joyfulness, your sense of fun, all of that party animal and spirit is exactly what you need. That is your greatest strength. You need to ignite that passion from within yourself all the time, and then just have people just dragged along in your wake because of your incredible joyful spirit. You need to get that optimism back and be that person, and that will just solve everything for you. And this is the first one, actually, that I'm going to actually pick one of these one of my guardian angel cards for, because I haven't actually used those yet. They've just been decorative so far. Where am I going, spirit? Where am I going? Where am I going? This way. Prayer. Okay. So we've got a prayer for you. Dear God, help me always to remember that the present life is but a fleeting moment within eternity. Help me to always remember that this life is but a dream. Help me to always remember that you exist within everyone and everything. Help me to always remember that love is all there is and all else is an illusion. Thank you. Okay. So I hope that helps you, Saj. It's going to be a fantastic couple of months for you, July to September, when you really start to reawaken that love within yourself again. And that's when you start to be showered with that love and abundance coming back towards you. I hope that helped. Hope it made sense. And please feel free to comment, like, and share the video. Let me know if you'd like to be entered in my free readings prize draw as well. And if you'd like to book a reading, just click on one of the links below the video. Have a great July, and I'll speak to you soon.